وجعلوا لله أندادا ليضلوا عن سبيله قل تمتعوا فإن مصيركم إلى النار.
One of the challenges we face is working in Lamu Island because of the terrain. Working with the district health management teams, we are mandated as Afya Plus to also improve quality of services in the smaller islands like Faza and Kizingitini. We find that our staff cannot access those islands in any other way other than using and hiring boats and fuel it and also pay the coxswain to take us to the island. The biggest challenge with the islands is the high tide, because you have only a limited amount of hours that you can work in an island.
I remember one day we were going to Faza sub-district hospital. I had never been there before, it was my first time. The waves were so high, higher than even the boat could accommodate. So it was like we were going up the wave and down into the water. The water was getting into the boat. We were so wet. I had carried some reports and some papers. They were all wet. My diary was wet. I was even worried if my laptop would come back to life.
It was only fortunate that there was there was a speedboat that was coming for the Kenya police, who really rescued us. They managed to get hold of the boat. It was really a difficult situation, and instead of going to the island, we decided even to come back and rescheduled our visit in another day. We felt very bad because we had really planned. We have already mobilized people, health workers, to come for the forum, but because of the high tides and rain, we could not access the health facility, and that was really a bad experience from our side.
It was so challenging. I felt scared, thinking of what I had left behind. I had a 3-month son by then, and I am not shy to say that I don't know how to swim for real. So actually I was depending on the life jacket. I didn't know if it could save me at that time. I actually prayed a lot that day. I felt even closer to God than any other time before.
If you cross over to Faza, you have to do it as early as 6 a.m. And if you are to leave, you must leave by 10 a.m. because the tide then gets unmanageable.
The sea has its own challenges. We have been waiting for almost 1 hour now, waiting for a boat to come and collect us to take us to the next point, which, according to me, there is a lot of time we are wasting. Another thing that scares me most is meeting another boat. Very high speed. It sends the waves into a crazy motion. If you are caught unawares, you can even be thrown into the water.
These are the challenges that we face every day we are crossing to the islands. Sometimes you spend even 2 hours in the water. When you sit on the behind, you might get wet because of the water splashing onto you. And while you sit on the front, the shakes are too wild for you. You can even vomit.
The challenge we also face in Lamu is that most of the DHMT or the District Health Management team are based on the island, mainly operating from King Fahad Hospital. And they also have to backstop the staff that are in the islands like Faza and Kizingitini. They also face the challenge of funding because the bank account is also in the island, and therefore sometimes the facility has to be left unmanned, as the only the clinical officer or the only medical officer takes a boat to go and bring supplies or to bring the necessary funding that is needed to run activities.
When we come with commodities, we have to transport by speedboat to the district hospital. We cannot access this island when it rains, because most of the speedboats are not covered. So you have to wait until when the weather is conducive for one to travel by the sea, and that leads to delay sometimes in implementing some health activities in this island, like outreaches, where you have to go to the community and offer service where the people are.
I am more efficient if I move around on a motorbike, and gladly I do have a reliable motorbike from the program. It is a very interesting mode of transport because you can get anywhere you'd like at a very cheap cost, and it's time saving and fuel efficient and quite reliable. Well, however, it comes with its ups and its downs. The downside being when the weather is awful. When it rains, it becomes quite a challenge to get from one point to another. You have to keep stopping to take cover from the rain. Lamu is essentially not well developed. The infrastructure is still quite backward. We don't have tarmac roads. So you can imagine a motorbike on a muddy road. It's quite tricky. The other challenge too could be the wild animals. We do have wild animals around. You come across buffalo, hippopotamus, you come across some wild dogs, you come across the baboons, and you have to be quite careful about that, because if you approach them in a manner likely to startle them, then they will defend themselves. I've had occasions where I have to stop and turn back because there's a hippopotamus that will not move. It's right across the road, and I have to use my skills, not to negotiate, no, but to escape and come back later on. You can imagine you don't have a spare wheel. You can imagine you don't have any kind of body cover. If you have a breakdown, then it's up to you, up to whatever skills you have, to save yourself. I've had to undergo that a few times whereby I had a mechanical breakdown, and it was deep between Witu and Mukunumbi. Then there's that forest over there, and the telephone network is almost nil at that place, and the sun was setting. Well, I had to use the little mechanical skills that I have to start the motorbike, and it went for 1 kilometer, it started again, and I kept pushing it, you know, until I managed to get to a point where I could get on phone and call some reinforcement. And luckily, somebody came over with another motorbike, with a rope, and I was towed for the remainder of the journey. That was approximately 20 kilometers to Mpeketoni, arriving at about 10 in the night.
But the staff have taken this in their stride, and it's building them in terms of their career and their understanding of the needs of the people in Lamu.
I love my job. I have to go to FASA. I have to help people work in FASA. I have to improve the working conditions in FASA, in Kizingitini. It's part of my job. I like it. No matter how challenging, how risky it is, I believe we are there to serve the people, and some other people are serving them, so I have no point of worry. Despite being risky, it's fun. I'm having a lot of fun.
It's been quite an inspiring moment working with the communities. There's a lot that inspires somebody. Working with the communities is totally different from working in the cities, offices, and all that. There are challenges. There are numerous challenges with the communities. Sometimes you have to really use a simple language. With the communities, you have to do what they do. You cannot dictate the communities. You have to humble yourself and be part of them. Should you get there and try and dictate whatever you want to achieve, then definitely it's a no-no, you will not get much.
We have a very dedicated team of staff who are drawn both from Lamu and from Coast Province. And they are very dedicated, they understand the people, they understand the terrain. And therefore, it is not uncommon to find that they are in Faza Island, providing support supervision or, you know, running monitoring visits, just to make sure that those people in the hard to reach areas are receiving the services that we are supposed to give, and especially quality services.
This is the residential place for most people here in Lamu. We have been here for quite some time. We have interacted with the community around this place, and we have really enjoyed the community support. As you can see, this island is highly populated. We have done a lot to this island. We have done some outreaches even to the farthest part of this island. People normally walk or use donkeys to reach to their destination. It's quite interesting, and for us as the program staff, we are really used to it, and now we can really walk to the street freely and provide our services without any difficulties.